The next question. Can you please explain the relationship between birth and karma? Understand the truths about karma first. Karma is of three types. Sanjita means all the karmas which you accumulated in all the births which you took from zero to now. If you have been a fish or tortoise or buffalo or man or different human births, everything, all put together is Sanjita. Next, Agamya means after taking birth in this body, what all you accumulate is Agamya. And third, Prarapta. Prarapta means the karma out of which you made this body, what you wanted to live in this body. Please understand. Sanjita is the whole bank balance. Prarapta is the part which you brought with you to live in this body is Prarapta. Agamya is what you are accumulating here. Now, the knowledge, life solutions, clarity about the purpose of birth, all these things will make you stop accumulating Agamya, new karmas, accumulated karmas. It will stop. And going along with your biomemory, purpose of birth, will exhaust all the prarapta which you brought to spend as your body. That will be exhausted. And you need proper meditation technique and master's grace to burn the Sanjita, which is old bank balance. That is why in many of our meditation programs, especially people who want to achieve enlightenment as their life's purpose, like a brahmachari, or sannyasis, vanaprasthis, we give a meditation called Mrigasariravasa. See, the Indian astrology very clearly gives you an understanding about from which animal body you took the jump to the human body. Each nakshatra is associated with one animal. Now, if you know your birth star, nakshatra, and that animal, meditating on that animal, trying to become that animal, allowing that animal engrams like a hunger, anger, lust, greed, fear of that animal, that animalistic instincts and quality, if that can be expressed through your body, if it can be thrown out of your system, please understand, any karma which is thrown out of your system through meditation techniques leaves you once for all. If it gets suppressed in you, it comes out in all your activity. You can see very clearly, when you become angry, some special animal qualities will be radiating through you. If you become angry, you can see, you are feeling that anger in the teeth and in the nail, tip of the nail. Means whenever animal is angry, it will use the teeth and nail to attack the enemies. Human beings also, many times you can see, whenever you feel angry, you will feel in the nails and in the teeth. Means that animal instinct is coming out. So all those animal instincts, lust, anger, hunger, fear, greed, arrogance, the restlessness, everything, if it is expressed through the body, through proper meditation technique, if it is released in the air, you are liberated. Please understand, if you don't release it in the air, you will vomit it on somebody else. If you are vomiting on somebody else, you will create again a chain of karma. You will vomit your anger on him. He will vomit his anger on somebody else or on you back. The karma chakra is created. Same way lust. If you are vomiting on somebody, then that person will give you some bondage. Then karma chakra is created. Instead of vomiting on some person, if you release it in the air, then you are liberated. That is what is the technique called Mriga Sharira Vasa. For 21 days, every day, morning once, evening once, two cycle means morning 42 minutes, evening 42 minutes. If you enter into the animal of your birth star, nakshatra, remember that animal, visualize it very clearly, you become that animal and express all the animalistic instincts through your body. Do not touch any other person. When you are releasing those samskaras, no person should touch you, or you should not touch any persons. You should have your space. Your space means that your breathing space should be for yourself. Nobody should be there in your breathing space. Better to be alone in a room or have enough space around you. Around you, become that animal, release those anger, release the violence, release the lust, release the greed, release the fear, release everything in the air. You will see you are liberated. In your day-to-day action, that violence, that anger, that lust, that engrams will not express. You will become like a flower. You will be so graceful. You will burn all the sanjitas. You will exhaust all sanjitas. You will be liberated. So please understand, let you be liberated, let you be free, let you be relaxed through this Mriga Sharira Vasa meditation. So you should find out your birth star and the animal related to that birth star. Indian astrology gives very clearly the animal related to your birth star. So now, the relationship between birth and karma. As I described, karma is of three types. So, based on that karma, you pick up the place of birth, body which you want, and the situation, everything. So now, in this birth, if you decide through the life solutions and constantly remembering the great truths, not to accumulate agamya, not to accumulate any karma, and by constantly living based on the purpose of your birth, biomemory, exhausting your prarabdha, and through this meditation technique, Mriga Sharira Vasa, exhausting, releasing all the sanjita, old karmas, you will be like a flower, you will be a jivan mukta, liberated being. So naturally, you will have the freedom to take next birth or not to take next birth. You will be free from karma and births. But as long as there is a karma left, you need to take births. When the karmas are exhausted, you can be liberated. So this is the relationship between birth and karma. Thank you. Dear one and all, namaste. Next questions. People ask, when it is easier to live a normal life with a regular job and a family, why bother about the purpose of life and struggle for enlightenment? What is your response to this? Please understand, the question starts, people ask, this itself shows it's a myth. If you ask this question, I'll answer. No single individual can ask this question. It is when it is easier to live a normal life with a regular job and a family. No. A person who lives with a regular job and a family can never make this statement. He knows how difficult that is. Please understand, the very question you need to understand. People ask, means what? Somebody asking, no. You say, do you have this question? Many times I have seen people come and ask me, Swamiji, one of my friend asked about a question about the sexual topic. I tell them, no. Do you ask? Do you have this question? Please understand, many questions we put on somebody means we don't have. Sometime we have, we want to hide on somebody else's name due to some reason. Sometime we don't even have, just put it on somebody else's name. If you have and you are putting it on somebody else's name, it cannot be answered. If you don't have and you are putting it on somebody else's name, again it cannot be answered. If you have, put it on your name. If you don't have, don't ask. Here, this question, the person who is asking does not have, is putting it on somebody. Please understand, only your question can be answered, not hypothetical question. When it is easier to live a normal life with a regular job and a family. No, it is not easy. Be very clear. It is not easy as we talk, as the statement says. Why bother about the purpose of life and struggle for enlightenment? If you think it is easy to live a normal life with a regular job and family, don't bother about anything. Just live that. Then you are living. Live happily, no problem. Only when things, when you and your life does not fit with each other, the seeking starts. Seeking starts. So, please understand, for everybody, seeking starts. But it goes in different direction. For somebody, it goes in suicidal tendency. For somebody, it goes in like a entertainment. For somebody, it goes like addiction. See, when that seeking starts, if you just want to forget about it by entertaining yourself in something, that is entertainment. TV or media or cinema or drama or music, something. If you want to forget about that through some substance, addiction, alcohol, smoking, drinking, or what not, all those things. If you want to forget about it by depressing yourself, that is suicidal. People take these three different routes. Very few, very intelligent, take the route of seeking the truth. Seeking the truth. So please understand, everybody is seeking, but it gets diverted in these three different directions. Very few intelligent people enter into the path of meditation or enlightenment. So, first statement, when it is easier to live a normal life with a regular job and family, is a myth. If it is easier, then live happily, don't bother about anything. When it is not, only then all these questions like a purpose of life, struggle for enlightenment, everything starts. So, do not cheat yourself. Everything is normal, good. When there is a seeking, do not divert it through different ways. When that fire of seeking starts, do not divert that fire through addiction. Pouring alcohol will not quench that fire. Do not divert that fire through entertainment. Entertainments will not quench that fire. Do not divert it through depression. Depression will not quench that fire. Awaken that fire. Purify your whole being and become enlightened. So please understand, the truth is, everybody is seeking, because the life and the personality does not fit. That seeking gets diverted in different direction. Now it is time for you to center it, awaken it, and lead to enlightenment. Understand, when an enlightened being smiles and laughs, radiates the joy, it is totally different. When an ordinary person smiles and laughs, it is totally different. The quality is different. So, you need to understand, ordinary person feeling normal, enlightened person feeling normal. There's a big difference. There is a big difference. You need to understand. Next question. In our current commercialized environment, is there a possibility for a loving spiritual ambience in which the baby can be born? I always felt the need to create this kind of an hospital. Hospital where all doctors and nurses are radiating enlightenment. Jivan Mukta doctors, Jivan Mukta nurses. a beautiful, peaceful, loving, caring ambience, just to bring life to the planet Earth and just to give farewell to the beings who are leaving the planet Earth, just for that. Like a place where the babies can be delivered, and a hospice where the terminally ill people who are really going to leave the body can be taken care. I always felt kind of a cosmic airport to be created with all medical care and this energy of enlightenment. Maybe with the divine will, and all the people who are interested in this concept will create this into reality, will make this vision into reality. I always felt there should be a place where this idea of Jivan Mukti is practiced, and the very air is filled with this presence, and so that life can land in the planet Earth in a conscious way, and lives can leave the planet Earth in a very conscious way without any fear. In those days, traditional methods have been used, like a Kathopanishad will be taught and Bhagavatam will be recited, taught to a person who is about to leave the body, who is ready to leave the body. So he is not having any fear or greed. He is relaxing, restful, clearly prepared to leave into the relax, into the cosmos. Still in Tibet they do. They read many sutras and techniques and spiritual things before they leave the body and after they leave the body, to make the soul peace and rest in bliss. So I always felt there should be a place, space created, maybe soon by the divine grace and the support of all the devotees and disciples, will make this dream into, will make this vision into reality.